Hello from Grafana. Let's talk about a new cloud migration tool. This is a new feature available in public preview in Grafana 11.2 coming out in August 2024. I'm Mitch. I'm the Director of Product Management working with the Grafana team. We'll start with the problem this feature solves. So imagine that, like me, you've just set up Grafana on your home computer to monitor something like your MacBook or your Raspberry Pi. So here I've got a couple of dashboards running on localhost, one that shows me the weather conditions in different cities, and another that shows me the state of my MacBook. You can tell I bought way too much computer for a product manager. But let's say I want to share this dashboard with somebody over the public internet. That's impossible for me right now because I'm running on localhost. Or imagine a totally different scenario where you're running Grafana Enterprise on-premise with hundreds of users for your company, but you'd prefer the convenience and the extra functionality of Grafana Cloud. So for example, maybe you want to use Grafana On-Call, App Observability, or one of the other products that we sell in Grafana Cloud. There's tons of functionality here that's not available in open source. So how do you move the things over that you've already created in your open source or enterprise instance, like dashboards and data sources? So this is already possible to some extent by using our APIs or using CLI tools, and you can learn about those in our migration guide documentation. But what we've created here is a much simpler point-and-click UI for migrating your things from Grafana Open Source or Enterprise over to Grafana Cloud. So here's how it works. In my open source instance, it's also available in Enterprise, under Administration General, I see an option to migrate to Grafana Cloud. This gives me some on-screen instructions and a blue button, which invites me to create a Grafana.com account to set up my cloud stack. In this case, I've already set up a cloud stack. So I'm going to go and find the mirrored option in my brand new cloud instance, Migrate to Grafana Cloud, which allows me to generate a token. And this token provides the connection details and the credentials for me to connect my on-prem instance to that cloud stack. The next step is to build a snapshot, which goes through my instance and collects all of the migratable resources. Right now, this feature supports just dashboards and data sources. That's part of this being in public preview. But in the future, we intend to add things like plugins, so you can migrate your panels and data source plugins, as well as alerts, annotations, and other Grafana resources. So next, I press one button, upload snapshot. And that migrates all of those dashboards and data sources over to my cloud instance. So now when I go into dashboards and refresh the page, I can see all of the dashboards that I just migrated over. So this is great. It's migrated my dashboards and data sources. So I can see that weather overview dashboard that I created. However, when I click into the Mac overview, I see some errors. And that's because the Prometheus instance that I'm running on my local machine is not accessible over the public internet. But there's a solution for this too. This migration tool is compatible with Private Data Source Connect. Private Data Source Connect allows me to connect my network secured resources, which in my case are on my computer, but they could also be in a virtual private cloud, on a public cloud provider, or otherwise in a private network. All I need to do is to deploy an agent in my private network that establishes a connection between my private network and Grafana Cloud so that I can query that data source. So here I've deployed the agent, and when I turn it on, I can see that it's connected. That means when I go into the data source that I just migrated over from my on-prem instance, I can choose to connect it through that PDC connection. And once I've created that connection, my dashboard loads, even though it was based on private data. This is great. So there are some important limitations to this migration tool as it stands. So right now, we can move over data sources, but if you've created a data source based on a plugin that you've downloaded, that data source won't work until you install that data source in Grafana Cloud. So for example, I had this AstraDB data source that was based on that plugin, and that plugin's not installed. So I need to install it before this data source will work. But once I install it, it will work right away. The second thing is, like I mentioned, this currently works for dashboards and data sources only. So things like alerts and annotations won't migrate directly. However, you can follow our migration guide, like I mentioned before, to use the API or CLI tools to migrate those extra instances. But one of my favorite things about this feature, just to mention, is the ability to securely migrate your data sources along with their credentials. So in the past, you had to recreate all your data sources because we didn't have a secure way to move the passwords or the tokens along with the other configuration details. But now that's just a one button push, and you don't have to go and ask for all those passwords or ask your users to reconfigure their data sources. So this feature is in public preview. That means that we recommend you test it out, but don't rely on it in production quite yet. So in your on-prem instance, you also need to enable a feature toggle to use it. Feature toggles are tools we use for features in public preview. The feature toggle for this one is called on-prem to cloud migrations. So that's this one. So you enable this in your on-prem instance in 11.2 or higher, and you'll be able to use this feature. We'll turn this on by default once it's generally available in a later release. So this feature is free to use. It's available in Grafana Open Source and Enterprise. Note that once you migrate to Grafana Cloud, we have the most generous free tier around, but you do pay to use Grafana Cloud once you exceed those free tier limits, which I think are pretty high. So please feel free to check out our migration guide, the docs, or just try the feature out to learn more. Thanks.